question I get asked a lot is, how do you set the dials on the MIG welder? Where do you start? How do you know what to set it at for like a piece of 16 gauge versus a piece of like quarter inch? Come here, I'll show you. So on the 251 Miller was nice enough to give us a chart. Because, you know, rough settings, so we can kind of start from, you know, where to start from. So, here, come here, take a look. Come here. And you could probably find this on the Miller site if you looked around for it. You got a chart that shows you, you know, asks you, what are you welding? Steel. You know, steel for outdoor, windy applications, stainless, aluminum, you know. It suggests wire type, solid core or flux core, for, you know, stainless wire, aluminum wire, shielding gases, that's the stuff in the bottle, 100%, you know, I mean, it's all right here. It spells it all out for you. Different wire sizes. I'm running 035 wire in this machine right now, so we'll set the machine up for that. And then it shows you the different sizes of metal. Half inch, all the way down to 22 gauge. So I've got a piece of 16 gauge sitting on the bench, and we're running 035 with a mix gas. So it's 75% argon, 25% CO2. So we know we want to start with about 16 amps and about 165 on the wire. So come around the other side of the machine, come around the front over here, and we'll set it up there and just see how that works. So we want 16 on the volts. 16, come on, fingers. And we want 165 on the wire. Always going to be difficult. Close enough. Okay, so let's put our helmet on, and we'll come over to the table, and we'll give that a try, and then we'll look at what it does, and figure out if we want to raise it up or lower it down. Okay, so let's just run a little bead, and we'll see how the settings work. Watch your eyes. This is the first little part that I did where a cork with MIG welders, especially one with an extra long cable, is you have to purge the cable first thing in the morning to get your shielding gas back up to your tip again. So that first little bit I did right there, I didn't have any shielding gas. That's why it sounded different. That's why it made a little bit of a mess right there. And then I started over, and I put a bead down, and it worked just fine, because I had gas. Okay, so looking at the weld, you can see the weld turned out really nice. It's nice and flat, you know, it's smooth, there's no big gaps or anything in it. But you can see it's a little lumped up, see it's kind of tall right in here, where it didn't get a lot of penetration. And that's either the wire feed was a little too fast, or the amperage was a little too low, or maybe I just moved a little too quick. Let me just mess with the controls. Let me turn the amperage down a little, and I'll turn the wire feed up a little, way out of proportion, just so you can see the difference. Hang on.
How much of the time do you have to sort of interpret what you're doing and just kind of get the feel of it and know what you're doing?
All the time. All the time. Those gross settings over there are just kind of a starting point. but you really have to take into account the metal that you're working on, how thick it is. Is it clean? Is it dirty? Are you inside? Are you outside? I mean, these are all different things that you have to keep in mind as you're working. And you have to change as situation as the situation changes as you're working itself. So, you know, what the setting that'll work right now, 5 minutes from now may be wrong. You may have to go over and give it a little more amps or a little more wire or a little less, you know, and you really just got to kind of play with it. And it's just something you learn over years of experience.
Are there any sounds you can listen for?
Oh, yeah. We'll talk about that in a minute. Hang on. Okay, so I turned the amperage down.
To what?
To 14.7. Just gave it a twist. And I turned the wire feed up to 200. Now, go ahead, put your helmet back on. Let's see what happens now. Boy, does that make a mess. Pick your helmet up. Here, come on over here. See this?
Oh my gosh.
Big difference, huh?
What a mess.
Yeah. Now see, that's too cold and the wire's too fast. And you hear it hop and skip and pop and carry on. And it, you know, it skips in the middle of the weld right there because the wire's coming out so fast you can't get a steady bead going. So let me turn the controls the other way now, and we'll see the difference over there. So now we're up at 18 volts and only 135 on the wire feed. So now lots of amperage and very little wire. Put your helmet up. Ready?
Go.
Now, that sounded a lot better. Here, come here and take a look. See the difference?
That's pretty.
Yeah, this is pretty good. See, this is a little high right in here, where I was may have been moving a little too fast. But this was starting to sink down in, where I slowed down a little bit, and that's where the extra amperage was coming into play, the extra voltage, where it was starting to penetrate into the metal. But you can hear the difference in the sound. More like bacon sizzling rather than firecrackers going off. You know what I'm saying? So that's kind of how it works. You got to play with it. You got to practice with it. But keep trying. You'll get there.
Did you learn this in school, Kevin?
No, I did not learn this in school. Thank you for bringing that up. I am self-taught. I have learned all this on my own. So, I'm not a professional in any shape or form. Take everything that I say right here on this video with a grain of salt. This is just stuff I have learned, I have taught myself how to do. So, if it's wrong, I apologize, but it works for me. So, until next time.